Hey, AT from CNC at home. When working with the laser, I've got a webcam that I repurposed. It's connected to the laptop that drives the laser and the router. The software for the laser that I'm using is called LightBurn, and it has an area for connecting the webcam so I can monitor what this is doing as it's cutting, so I can actually monitor it from the computer. I don't have to be in this room to see it, which is really nice. It also has the feature of taking the camera, and if you calibrate the camera in the software, if it can see this area, you can use it like a scanner. I can put something down here. I can put my hand down here and scan my hand. And then that comes in as an image, and I can do an edge trace with that and then do a laser burn. When I'm doing the burning, when I put my material in here that I'm going to burn, whatever that may be, whether it be a piece of paper, let's say I put a tablet in here, and I have it a little bit, you know, kittywampus. What the camera can do, again, once it's calibrated, is the image in the LightBurn software then can be rotated and sized to match what I'm burning on. And it's relatively accurate, too. So as long as you don't need, you know, 0.001 accuracy, if you can have a, you know, half a millimeter or so of variance, this is fantastic. I can take and see where this is, rotate the image in the software. It superimposes it right on top of what I'm going to burn, so I can see pretty much what it's going to look like. So we're going to do some experiments. I'm working with my brother on trying to figure out where this can go. I want to attach it to the frame of the laser. The easy way to do it would be just to attach it to the wall up here somewhere, and then I'm set. The problem is, if the laser moves at all, I have to go through and recalibrate the whole thing so that it's positioned correctly. And this is not fixed down, so it's better to have the camera somehow attached to the laser itself. This obviously is too close. It needs to be up here. I did some measurements. I want to attach it to this back rail, right in this T-slot. I can use a couple T-nuts in here, have something that comes up to hold this that's not too wiggly. And somewhere between, I believe it's 19 inches and 27 inches high, gets me down here most of the area. Up here, it can get the entire area. So the project is to figure out how we can create something on the back that's not too wiggly, that will support this fairly lightweight camera. And we'll have to figure out how to get this camera positioned so it doesn't move, because it does have this articulation in it that we need to eliminate. So that should be as easy potentially as just double sticky taping or using some Velcro, something like that, to adhere that to the stand, aiming down at the appropriate angle. So anyway, that's kind of what the project looks like. Hopefully we can get this done. Again, connect that in with the LightBurn software and really use it to its full potential. I was able to get my webcam mounted on a little bracket. Let's take a look at it. It's nothing fancy. It's just a little bracket on this long dowel, and then just drill the hole in this chunk of wood. A couple of zip ties holds it all in place. These are items that I found in the garage that would work. So again, nothing fancy. The camera itself, very lightweight, so I don't need a whole lot of support. You know, it does wiggle a little bit, but while the laser itself isn't moving, or if I'm not jostling the table, just the laser head is moving back and forth, I don't need that to be stable. I only need it to be stable when everything else is static. So there's a couple of things that LightBurn has you do. They have you print out this little pattern, and then you position it in various spots around the bed, and you take a picture of it, and it analyzes the dot pattern to see what curvature there is from the lens. And then there's also this target that they have you print out. I'll turn it right side up here. And it basically just has four spots of known distance, and the camera then takes a picture of that, and then you identify the centers of each of these spots. And from that, it calibrates your working area. So once you've got it calibrated, you can place something onto the working surface that you want to cut on. All right, so let's say I wanted to cut on this red card, put some pattern on it. What I could do is I could set it down here, and what I've done in the past is I spent time making sure that it's square, run the laser around it, make sure that it's exactly where I need it to be, set my zero down here on the corner of the thing, and then burn it, and that works fine. What having the camera here allows me to do is it will take a picture of however this is. So if I just put this on here like so, take the picture from the webcam, then in the software it shows this to me, and I can put whatever design I want on here. I put it in the software, and then I can rotate it and position it exactly where this is. And if everything is calibrated correctly, I can just say burn, and the laser comes over here and it burns right in place. So there's a little fudge factor in there. It's not exactly perfect, but just with a little calibration and being careful of, you know, where things are positioned, it's a big time saver. So it's kind of some cool technology. Anyway, that's native right in the LightBurn software. If you haven't played with that, I would recommend doing it. It's been kind of beneficial. I've done a few things with it, so I give that functionality a thumbs up.
Oops.
Hi, I'm AT from CNC at Home. If you like our content, help support our channel by clicking on subscribe and liking our videos. Thank you for watching this video. Have fun with your CNC at Home projects.